Two cities from Rajasthan have been selected in the first list of smart cities. How's the mood in Rajasthan?
Mood in Rajasthan is fantastic, and one more aspect is associated with this. Apart from the selection, the conversion rate is highest, the best in the state. Because if you compare with the other states, like Madhya Pradesh, there three cities have been selected. But in the original proposals, there were seven cities. So three out of seven, if we compare two out of four. So percentage-wise, conversion-wise, Rajasthan has performed best.
For a common man, what is a smart city?
Smart city to Aam Aadmi, to me, as I mentioned in my presentation also, under the smart city, everything should be easily available. And the citizen, the facilities and utilities should be citizen-centric. I mean, we should not create any facility which only a particular class can enjoy. It should be accessible, it should be easily approachable, it should be cost effective, and it should be right in the bedroom or at the thumb print of the citizen.
Touch
opportunity. And it should not be restricted only to the computer savvy at the same time. I mean, if those who are unable to use the computer, they are not computer savvy. Like those who are living in slums, like those in small pockets, those who are just coming as a commuter for livelihood, they should also be having the access to the minimum requirement of the civic services. For example, like water supply, like for sewerage, like for housing, like for transportation. There should be public transport, focus on public transportation. Yeah. If somebody wants to use and go to the places on a non-motorized traffic mode, like by using own cycle, like in foreign everywhere we go and we find that people are using non-motorized cycles. So there should be a facility to them.
Yes. How is the smart city project affecting the real estate market in Rajasthan?
Real estate definitely going to facilitate not only real estate, but I think all the manufacturing states, the sectors, be it a manufacturing, be it a public services, be it a employment, be it a any you take example of anything, like in the citizens also, those who are not directly connected, they will also feel elated if something is happening in their city which they were not expecting few years before. Someone might get the benefit of increase in the business opportunity, like they have been running their shops in certain area, suddenly there is a boom of tourism, so they are going to benefit. So not only particular sector, I'll see it an opportunity for everyone, including the citizen, including the people visiting that city, including the business community, everyone. Yeah. They will get it.
What steps are you taking to attract more private investments?
You see, already people have started approaching us. Once this first milestone has been crossed, already there is a beeline of public investors, private investors, as well as the foreigners, companies, they are coming. They want to have the partnership in one or some other manner. They want to provide their support, maybe in consultancy, maybe by arranging for funds, maybe by providing some technical know-how, maybe by capacity building. So we are getting tremendous inquiries. Hopefully, they'll all convert into reality.
How do you plan to make you people smarter?
People will definitely become smarter because we have to handle this smart city project. So we have to be smart, our people have to be smart, citizens have to be smart, because when a city has to be smart, then citizens have also to be smart. They have to develop the tendency to look smart. Like for example, like public open defecation, like wastage of water, wastage of sewerage, then wastage of resources, then some sense, some traffic sense. Everything is a part of a smart city concept. So without citizen support, this cannot be converted into reality. Until and unless citizens are cooperators, whatever the investment you can bring, whatever the investment you can make, but without public support, it is not going to be.